Hi guys, Nicole and Albert here from Relax My Dog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. On last week's vlog, Kawaii Potato asked us about how to cheer up her dog after the death of his playmate. Firstly, we're so sorry for your loss, but we are hoping that this video will help to cheer up your dog. This week, we're covering how to cure the signs of depression in dogs. There are a multitude of reasons why dogs can become depressed. A lot of these reasons will include a big change in their lifestyle, so this can be for anything from moving house to a human or playmate dying. So firstly, we're going to cover how to tell if your dog is depressed. Common signs of depression in dogs are excessive sleeping, a lack of appetite, and little to no interest in going on walks or playing with their toys. Now, if you are noticing all or some of these signs, then our first recommendation is to take your dog straight to the vets. This is because the symptoms of depression in dogs are very similar to that of arthritis, so they'll want to do some blood tests and maybe some x-rays to make sure that this isn't the cause. If the vet finds that there is nothing wrong with your dog's health, then it's safe to assume that your dog may be suffering with depression. Now, there are a number of things that you can do to help cheer your dog up, and we're going to run through some of those now. Now, our first suggestion is a nice long walk early in the morning when the sun's shining. Dogs are very similar to humans in this respect. The mixture of the fresh air and the sunshine will help increase your dog's mood and help him get through the day. Probably the most important tip that we're going to give you today is to just spend more time with your dog. Your dog craves the attention from you, and the more time you spend with him, even if it's just sitting on the sofa next to him, giving him lots of hugs and attention, that is going to cheer him up. He needs to know that you're there for him and that you love him and that you're going to make him feel better. Socializing your dog is a really, really good way of stopping the depression. Especially after the death of a loved one or a playmate, they're going to be craving companionship. You could take him to a socialization class or a dog park, anywhere where there's going to be some other furry friends for him to play with. After all, dogs are pack animals, so same species socialization is really, really effective in curing depression in dogs. Now, it's really important in all of this to make sure that you stay happy. Dogs can sense the atmosphere inside your house, so if there's a negative atmosphere there, they're going to bounce off from these feelings. So every time you're at home with your dog, make sure that you're giving out some positive energy, some positive vibes, because he's definitely going to respond to this. Now, make sure you keep your favourite treats with you whenever you're with your dog so that you can reward his positive behaviour. This is similar to obedience training, but it's rewarding him for any signs that he is getting over his depression. So eating normally, playing with his toys, going for a run, anything like this, this is all signs that he's getting over his anxiety or his depression. So make sure that you're rewarding him for that so that he associates those treats with his good behaviour. Another really good idea is to buy him some new toys. Now, ideally, it would be great if you could get some interactive toys that you can play with him. So playing fetch with your dog is great. Or some puzzle toys like a Kong, something that's going to take his mind off whatever is causing the depression and focus it all on those new toys. And our last top tip is obviously relax my dog music. Now, we've got a playlist that is purely for anxiety in dogs, and this is going to work perfectly if your dog is suffering with anxiety or depression. So I'm going to put the link for this in the description of this video. Just play this to your dog when you're with him or when you're without him, and hopefully it will help him to relax, calm down, and tackle whatever it is that's causing this depression or anxiety. So we really hope that this video is giving you some top tips on how to stop that depression in your dog. Now, Albie's getting much better. He was suffering with separation anxiety, but not anymore really, are you, mate? Relax My Dog music has really helped with that, as have all of the tips covered in this video. Now, we'd love to hear your suggestions for next week's video. We always love hearing those suggestions. So do put them in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, please do give us a big thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, then please make sure that you hit that button. Now, to go with this video, we have got a poll on. Has your dog suffered with depression? We'd love to know how many dogs do suffer with this. And if you've got any other tips on how to cure it, then please do put them in the comments below. So until next week, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Bye. everyone, Nicole and Albert here again for the Relax My Dog vlog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. This week, the video is all about how to reduce whining and crying in your dog. A lot of people seem to be having this difficulty at the moment. Whining and crying is a different way for dogs to communicate. This week, we're going to go through the different types of whining in dogs and how to stop them.